Hi guys, welcome to NumberX. In this lecture, we are going to learn how to find derivative of sine inverse of ax using first principle or definition of derivative. So let us start. Let sine inverse of ax is equal to y under given condition when x running from negative 1 to positive 1 and y running from negative pi by 2 to pi by 2. Under these conditions, we can take sine on both sides of this equation. Hence, we get x is equal to sine of y. This equation is nothing but a function of y. Hence, we can write f of y is equal to sine of y. Instead of finding dy by dx, we will find dx over dy. Okay. So, by definition of derivative, we can write f of y plus h minus f of y upon h when h tends to 0 under limiting condition. Now we will simply put the value of f of y plus h by replacing y by y plus h in this equation. Hence we get sine y plus h minus sine of y upon h when h tends to 0. Okay. Now by using sine a plus b is equal to sine a into cos b plus cos a into sine b identity, we can write sine y plus h is equal to sine y into cos h plus cos y into sine h. Remaining terms will remain same. Here we will arrange the terms and we can write this way. Okay. Advantage of writing in this form is we can take common factor sine y from these two terms and we get sine y times cos h minus 1 upon h plus cos y times sine h upon h when h tends to 0. Since y is not affected by variation of h, hence we can take it out and we can write this way. From here also, y is not dependent on h, hence we can take it out and we can write this way. Now we will take negative 1 common from this expression and we will get negative sine y times limit when h tends to 0 of 1 minus cos h upon h plus cos y times limit of sine h upon h when h tends to 0. By using the formula limit of 1 minus cos h upon h when h tends to 0 is equal to 0 and limit of sine h upon h when h tends to 0 is equal to 1, we can write this expression as 0 and this is equal to 1. Hence, dx upon dy is equal to cosine y and reciprocal of this term is equal to dy over dx is equal to 1 over cosine y. Now, our target is to write cosine y in terms of x. Okay. We know the identity sine square y plus cos square y is equal to 1. Hence, cos square y is equal to 1 minus sine square of y. This implies cos y is equal to plus minus square root of the quantity 1 minus sine square y. Since we have taken sine y is equal to x, hence we can replace sine y by x and we get cosine y is equal to plus minus square root of the quantity 1 minus x square. But wait here. Since sine inverse of x lies in the closed interval negative pi by 2 and pi by 2, hence y also lies in this interval because we have taken y is equal to sine inverse of x. This implies cos y lies in closed interval 0 and 1 because y is an angle which lie in first and fourth quadrant only. Okay. But one thing to note here, since cos y is in the denominator of dy over dx, hence it cannot be equal to 0. Okay. Now we will remove equality here and cosine y is greater than 0 and less than or equal to 1. By this inequality, we can clearly say that cosine y is positive quantity. Hence, we can remove negative sine from here. Okay. This implies dy over dx is equal to 1 over the quantity square root of 1 minus x squared. We can verify this fact by graphing sine inverse of x on Cartesian coordinate. By end of this, we have finished this lecture. If you like content of our video useful, please subscribe to our channel NumberX and hit the like button. I also request you to press the bell icon because we don't want that you miss any useful video uploaded by NumberX. Thanks for watching. Till then, goodbye.